the load, like everything we've done, will sit right in that frontal plane, right above the base. And I've got this midline I'm stabilizing, this angle that we're calling the hip angle, right? This alpha here. Now, whether we're doing, say, a back squat or a front squat, that load, whatever it is, will have some propensity, we call it a moment, to close that angle. Do you understand that? If I put 200 pounds on here, 400 pounds, as the weight increases, the tendency of that load to close that angle increases. Okay? Can you see that? I'm here to tell you that elevating it won't in and of itself increase that moment. Either the torsion about the point of the hip or about the length of the midline. Just because it's higher up doesn't make it any heavier. But any deviation of this thing forward at all will increase the effective moment arm on the torso and greatly increase the forces on the hip to close. Greatly increase it. For the same reason that whatever the load is up here, it's harder out here. And if that weight is perfectly over, sits perfectly above my base, stays exactly within the frontal plane, I have no problem managing it. But if there are any imperfections in either the posture of my squat or the dynamics of my squat, and you all have them, this overhead squat will increase the moment so dramatically that you'll find the challenge of the squat to be wildly magnified, amplified. And so what I have here is a great litmus, a great tool for exposing weaknesses in either the static, the structure, posture, or the dynamics, the line of action in your squat. Very, very potent tool. And so the back squat and the front squat, or some average, some combination of those two, speaks to your ability to usefully, to powerfully open the hip. The capacity you have at hip extension. But the overhead squat will measure my ability to extend that hip while controlling with the upper extremities and stabilizing with my in my along the midline. And discrepancies, they're sure to occur. I told you no one's squat is perfect, not in static or dynamic. Sometimes it's hard to see what's wrong with a squat statically. I get an overhead squat in there, and now all of a sudden we may find all kinds of boogers. But if your overhead squat is a fraction of your back or front squat, you potentially have capacity to extend the hip and unsafely under athletic loads. What that means is you can move weights with the hip that you can't control out of the upper extremities. And that suggests something rather negative for sport application, for functional use.